This video is brought to you by VIRCI, a science and technology company offering research and development and consulting. Welcome to the second episode of this four-book astronomy series. As promised in the last episode, we will be talking about the ongoing magnetic pole shift and the mini ice age. Starting with what could possibly cause the pole shift. Now, cause number one could be Earth's transition through the galactic plane's opposite sides. The solar system moves through the Milky Way galaxy through cyclical motion. The second cause could be a pole shift caused by passage of large asteroids, comets, or large celestial bodies, which is another major factor to a magnetic pole shift. A large asteroid or planet-sized celestial body or large comet passing through our solar system and or in close proximity to Earth. This could have a major effect on Earth's magnetic pole axis. Another possible cause for the pole shift would be the moon swap factor. By viewing historical evidence from indigenous tribes and written recorded history from old cultures, we find many references to a difference in the alignment of Earth with the other planets in the solar system. Also, the scientist and writer Emmanuel Velikovsky, in his book, Worlds in Collision, describes a cataclysmic celestial event that had a major effect on our solar system. My conclusion is that Earth had a different moon than our current moon. Something cataclysmic probably happened to reshuffle the planetary alignment. Another possible cause for the pole shift is by unknown factors. Now, from a human perspective, we are still in the early stages of discovering and understanding astronomy. As our civilization advances technologically and starts conquering space, we need to also advance morally and spiritually. If we advance only technologically, but lag behind in morality, spirituality, and social consciousness, our civilization would eventually collapse backwards. The distance between the Sun and Earth is not the only factor to the variations of temperatures on the surface of Earth, as mainstream science assumes. Less than 0.01% of distance differential does not account for such a large temperature variable between the poles and the equator areas. Factors that affect weather and temperature. The direct sunlight exposure and atmospheric air pressure interacting with the sun's currents, the angle of refraction of the sun's frequencies with the outer edge of the atmosphere, the torus or toroidal shape of the magnetosphere.
The sun's electric current, consisting of a large spectrum of frequencies or radiant energy,
interacts with the different layers of the atmosphere that are comprised of different combinations and concentrations of gaseous elements and particles. The angle of refraction of the sun's frequencies. The outer edge of the atmosphere has an effect of refracting or reflecting the solar rays at different angles and different areas of the curvature of the outer edges of the atmosphere. And finally, the torus or toroidal shape of the magnetosphere. The toroidal shape of the magnetosphere keeps the pole regions exposed to the extreme cold, freezing temperatures of outer space due to the toroidal shape causing openings in the pole regions. Note that the outer space, or vacuum slash ether, is very cold at temperatures of minus 270 Celsius, or minus 454 Fahrenheit. The following are the main factors for the pole's extreme cold temperatures. The official scientific theory of the sun's radiant heat reacting with the outer shell and the distance and angle of the light rays hitting Earth affecting temperature levels from the equator to the poles is one factor. The extreme cold temperature at the poles is due to the following three factors. Number one, solar radiation slash sun's energy. The electric solar current, the radiant energy of a wide spectrum of frequencies emitted by the sun, interacts with Earth by penetrating the magnetosphere and the atmosphere. The sun's current interacts with different gases and elements that comprise the specific layers of the atmosphere. The second factor is the toroidal shape of the magnetosphere keeps the poles frozen cold due to the shape of the torus having openings in the pole regions like an apple. These openings in the poles keep the polar regions exposed to the extreme cold temperature of outer space. And the third factor is the current flow through the poles. The cold current of ether slash dark matter is pulled in at the poles from outer space by the centrifugal spin of the solid inner core and the induction effect of the inner solid core's out-of-sync spin with the outer shell. The inner solid core and the mantle slash crust have two different and distinct magnetic polarization due to their differences in shape and material composition. The out-of-sync spin in conjunction with the sun's current and the moon's anchoring grip on the shell of Earth creates the three-part generator effect, which in turn generates the north-south magnetic field and the magnetosphere. If you would like more information on the three-part generator effect, I would recommend that you go back to episode 1 of Keredine's Rosetta Stone of Astronomy. Since the inner core of Earth is solid and spins independently of the outer crust slash mantle, the magnetic pole shift will first cause the inner solid core to shift or tilt on its axial angle, which would put pressure on the outer crust, because neither the inner core nor the outer crust is a perfect sphere, but rather they are wider on their equators, just like a tangerine. This would cause outward pressure on the crust in the direction of the core's shift and affect the outer crust as a secondary effect due to the push, drag, and friction effect coming from the shifting torus solid core. This inner core's shift or tilt would cause the toroidal shaped magnetosphere to also shift and tilt, and consequently would expose a new geographic area to extreme cold weather due to the opening in the torosphere moving into a new geographical region, expanding the frozen polar region and causing a mini ice age. This could have drastic consequences on Earth's weather. Depending on the severity and extent of the magnetic pole shift, the consequence to tectonic plates movement and volcanic eruptions will be proportional to how much the magnetic poles shift. The magnetic pole shift would cause a mini ice age, because the location where the magnetic poles would shift or tilt to and settle at would eventually become the new geographic poles. Due to the toroidal shaped magnetosphere shifting with the magnetic poles, the opening of the toroidal sphere at the exposed polar areas would relocate to a new region on the planet. This would create new magnetic and geographic pole regions aligned together. However, this period of transition from the old geographic poles to the new geographic and magnetic poles would temporarily create four frozen regions on the planet, and that would be a period of ice age on Earth. It would take some time for the frozen pole regions to melt away and align with the new magnetically shifted and created geographic pole regions. This shift process would cause an expansion of the cold frozen regions on the planet, from the old geographic poles and extending to the new magnetically shifted and created frozen poles. This change would significantly lower the temperature of the planet for an undetermined time period. The ice age period would last until the old geographic poles warm up, melt away, and realign with the newly created geographic poles. After the old geographic poles totally melt away, the temperature on Earth would reach a new equilibrium and the ice age period would end. Since the magnetic pole shift is something beyond our civilization's control and is a solar system slash galactic scale event, it is difficult to determine if it is a gradual or fast shift.
Climate change and global warming. Even though an ice age would be of significant environmental impact, it should not be used to diminish or dismiss climate change and global warming issues.
Climate change and global warming are real and valid issues and need to be addressed separately and independently of a potential magnetic pole shift induced mini ice age. Because an ice age would be an act of nature on a solar system scale, while climate change and global warming are man-made. The theory of the magnetic pole shift should not be used as an argument against climate change or global warming, because both pole shift and man-made climate change are two separate and distinct issues that are affecting the climate and life on Earth.
This book is part of a 4-book series, 3 of which are available right now on Amazon, Apple eBooks, and Barnes & Noble in eBook and paperback format. Stay tuned until next time, where we will talk about the Venus retrograde.